My name is Daniel, and I'm going to talk about how the culture or even the classical music is financing here in Slovenia. So I'm working with the Republic of Slovenia for Public Fund for Cultural Activities. We are calling it JSKD, and it's a governmental institution which was established to take care of amateur, so non-professional cultural societies and their associations. And we have to think about that this is on the all fields of culture, so for choirs, orchestras, theater, puppets, folklore dances, literature and movies. We are organizing festivals, seminars, and every year we are also funding projects of these non-professional societies on national and also on local levels. So if we are watching what is today, yes, today is the organization, one of the most effective cultural networks in the country, enabling directional communication between more than 5,000 cultural societies with over 100,000 members. And together we are creating over 25,000 projects per year, which are visiting nearly 4 million persons. And what about funding? So we are also taking care of classical music associations, but the system funding the non-professional and professional art is here different. The non-professional art is getting money from local municipalities, so cities, and also from local companies to make some advertisement or even to get some extra concerts for the companies. But in Slovenia, we are lucky. We are having a lot of luck because all national established cultural organizations, so professional ones like Slovenian Philharmonic Orchestra or Slovenian National Opera and Ballet Theater, are getting the most of its annual budget for salaries and for yearly program from Slovenian Ministry of Culture. Ministry is giving yearly around 90% of all money. And so the ticket income and income from the patrons or donations are lower than 10% of yearly budget.
Well, that sounds really great. Like 90% is like big deal of the of the budget. Yeah. It kind of makes everybody feel safe and more focused on the program rather than fundraising.
That's right. So we don't have so big in our national classical organization, we are not having so big part of the organization which takes care for funding, like in the USA or in other countries. So they're just dealing with the programs. But it has also pros and cons. So if I'm going to talk about pros and cons, here are just few of them. They're more absolutely, and pro are that this money is enough for normal work. But we must look that also the programs are usually then make like just ordinary. So we have stability of employment, and what is good for us as visitors, the low price of the ticket. But contrasts are that we are not able to create bigger and more powerful performances. So if you're going to the concert, especially the opera house, you have just normal one performance with not extra, let's say, how to deal with the stage and with some other very known names and so on. And we don't have like we have lack of connection with audience because we don't, like I said, we don't have this combination of how many persons is taking for communication with the audience, with the benefactors and so on. And we have smaller number of international productions, which is also very bad because I think today we must to have more combinations how to work with other countries and other houses of classical music.
Let me ask you a question. Would that mean that basically each institution will receive a budget for the next year, which is based on the approximate amount from the previous year, and then they deal with that? Or the institutions can make plans and programs, include even more expensive productions, and then receive funds for that? Would that be possible?
Yes, so the professional ones, they are every year at the end of the year, they are doing a report what are going to do next year. But they are normally looking at the same amount which they got last year, or and are planning on the same amount. So all the professional organizations, they are doing yearly program on the same amount, yes. If they want to do some extra projects, they need to go not to the governmental money, but to look other combinations, but they still not do. So there is a problem. And so if we are going to compare our organizations, so the Slovenian ones, with other classical organizations in EU, we need to take about some, and here some, we must to find these good practices. So one good practice is especially, and it was already in Slovenia, so in the time of Yugoslavia, that some of the tax establishments were better to deal with the culture. Today, it's like so that this tax is very good for non-professional. So associations, especially the humanitarian ones, and also the sport and the culture, where every person in Slovenia is giving, first it was 0.5%, now this year will be 1% of its tax return to the specific non-professional organizations. And this was in past year, so over 5,500,000 euros. And this is just 30% of what is possible to get, because out of person they did not mark who are going to put taxes, so this 1%. And so this was all, then all that money goes to the our government again back. But if we could create this, that everyone is going to know, so the brand and everything else, that where he's paying the money, I think all of persons are going to give 1% or more, also so for non-professional and also for professional ones, I think so. But we must to talk with this. Then we must to encourage the companies to cooperate, to do what we could find. So where is possibility in the economic situation, how do we present the donators, the benefactors, like also we talk in the previous presentation. So we must plan what is important for the what we could offer the business and what we could offer the foundations. And also now we must find in the next seasons more about EU financing. In Slovenia, we are not so pretty good with getting this money, but I think we are going to be better in the future, because we have some law which is a little bit different, and we hardly get the monies from the EU financing. And what is about this topical points for the future? So we must do more about artistic planning in the terms of the programs, not just for the next year, like now their professionalization do, but we must do a plan for, let's say, 5 years ahead, and what we are going to present and what we could do with, let's say, with that 10 million of euro for the season, and how we could find a solution to get, let's say, 5% for some other projection. Then we must do about institutional marketing. So this is not the program marketing. This is about to present the persons and the institutions like itself. So this is the topic of what we could offer to the business. So the like we are, some of our persons are going to do a commercial for some business and so on. And we could do this 5% from this. And then it's also programmatic marketing, which allows us that we find how to deal with money in the same program. And then we must look about the family and the boards. We don't have still boards like in the other EU countries or USA. But if we have this connection between families, so the visitors and their families, and with the boards, so with the some donors which we could include in our business, in our organizations, then we, I think, could spread the names and spread the ideas and spread the information to all others, and I think we could find more benefactors. And especially fundraising, which is especially established about how to deal with also getting money and how we also deal with spending it.